Okay guys, so today's lesson is going to be a pre-recorded lesson. As usual, we'll just go back to live lessons as of tomorrow, okay? So at any point throughout this PowerPoint, if I ask you to pause the video, that means I want you to do an activity that you can do in your book or on paper, okay? Pause it and then obviously unpause it to get the answers and continue on. You can take it at your own pace. Take as much time as you need, but the idea is that it is a full lesson long. There's 5 questions on the board that I'd like you to do as your starter for today. So if you want to get those done, guys, pause the video and we'll go over the answers when you unpause. So the answers are, don't forget to get the denominators the same in order to add. So you should have got 5 over 6. That number to one significant figure is 5,000. When your times in fractions, you multiply the top and then multiply the bottom. So it's 3 over 20. Factorising means to put into brackets, so you're looking for what's common in the 6 and the 4. So the common number is 2, and there's an x common as well. So 2x goes on the outside of your brackets. 2x times by 3x gets you 6x squared. So 3x goes inside the bracket, and then 2x times 2 gets you 4x. And then you end the bracket. Then it wanted the highest common factor of 28 and 35. So list all your factors of 28, all your factors of 35, and you will have got the highest common one of 7. So mark the ones you've done, put any correct answers in if you've made any mistakes. Today, guys, we're going to be looking at volume. So what I'll do is I'll gauge how far you got and how much you understood of this in tomorrow's lesson. So we might recover some of it in a revision lesson. But for the most of it, this lesson, this pre-recorded lesson, should explain it quite well to you. Okay. So before we go any further, we need to do some revision on the area of the following shapes. So can you just write on your paper or in your book what the formula would be for the 3 shapes that are on the screen now to work out the area of them? Okay, so if you pause the video, write the formula down and then we'll go over some answers. Okay, so for the first one, that's a parallelogram, you do height times base. So for that one, it would have been 5 times 8, okay? For the second one, bear in mind, I didn't want you to work any answers out for this, guys. I just wanted you to write the formula down. For the second one, that's a triangle. So the area of a triangle is height times base divided by 2. And the last one was a trapezium. And the area for a trapezium is a half of A plus B times the height. That might be the one that gets a few of you, okay, because it is the one that we tend to forget because it's a bit of a lengthy one. So here they are. I've written them out for you. So if you want to pause the video, guys, at any point and write these formulas down, you are going to need them today, okay? Area of a trapezium is a half of A plus B times the height. Area of a parallelogram is base times the height. And area of a triangle is height times base divided by 2. Okay, so a few questions on the board for you to just practice those formula skills now. Pause the video, answer maybe one of each. So choose a parallelogram, choose a triangle, and work those out for me now. Pause the video and we'll go over the answers after. Answers are now on the board. Okay, mark the ones you've done. Any mistakes you made, it's probably because you forgot to divide by 2 on some of the triangle ones. So just remember, height times base divided by 2. So these are all trapeziums, guys, and it's really important that you practice the area of a trapezium. Remember the formula, a half of A plus B times the height. A and B are the two parallel sides. If you look at the first one, A and B would be 3 and 11, and the height would be 8. So you'd do 3 out of 11 to get 14, okay, times that by 8, and you'd divide the answer by 2. So pause the video, have a go at those ones now, and we'll go over the answers in a second. Answers are on the board, okay? Make sure you're using squared units because this is area. So hopefully that's been a good bit of revision for those common area of shapes. So what we need to get onto now is volume. So on the screen now, you should see a range of 3D shapes. It's really important that you know the names of these shapes, okay? So I'd like you to pause the video and I'd like you to write down the names of these shapes. We'll go over the answers when you unpause. So, first one was a sphere, a cube is just a 3D square, and a cuboid is a 3D rectangle, okay? Really important, those two get mixed up quite a lot. Cylinder is the one that looks like a tube of Smarties or even a can of beans. Hexagonal prism, it just means that the end face is a hexagon and it's a prism. The next one is a cone, we tend to remember that one. The next one is like the pyramids you see in Egypt. That's a square-based pyramid. And the next one has got a triangular base, so we call that triangular-based pyramid. And then the last one is a triangular prism, okay? So make sure if you got any of those wrong that you look at them now and you know what their names are. So to start with, we need to understand what volume is. So what is volume? How would you describe volume? Okay, you might want to pause the video and have a think about that. But if we just go over it, volume is basically the inside space of a 3D object. Okay, so that is what volume is. So if you had to work out the volume of this cube, we should know that a cube have all the sides the same. Okay, so if we're working out the volume of this shape, we're trying to work out the inside space. So to do that, we know all the sides are the same. So we're going to do height times base times depth. Now, the reason we do height times base is we work out the area of the end face of the shape. So if you're looking at that cube, that face that's looking at you, that is a square. So the area of the square is height times base, which is 5 times 5. And then we times that by the depth, which is also 5. So the volume would be 5 times 5 times 5, which is 125 centimeters cubed. Volume is measured in cubed units. It's really important that you're not putting squared, so a little 2 on there, because that's for area. Volume is measured in cubed units, okay? You can pause it and take some notes on that if you want. So, I need you to write down this formula, guys. It's really important. A volume of a prism is the area of the repeating face, or the cross-section, times the depth. Now, a prism, guys, is that any shape where if you cut it up into slices, each slice would be the same size and same shape. So if you think about a bar of Toblerone, when you chop that up, every single square of Toblerone is the exact same shape. It's a triangle and the exact same size. So that is what we call a prism. Okay, so any shape that you can chop it up and get equal size shapes, then that is a prism. So make sure you've got that down. So if we're working out this example here, all this shape is it's a compound shape. It just means it's made up of two shapes that we know how to work the volume out of. So we've got effectively two cuboids here, okay? So we're going to split it up into cuboid 1 and cuboid 2. So big cuboid and small cuboid. So for the larger cuboid, okay, area of the repeating face, which is height times base, and then times it by the depth. So it's just 9 times 4 times 3, which is 108 meters cubed. And for the smaller one, again, height times base times depth. So 2 times 2 times 3 gives us 12 meters cubed. So our total volume is just the two volumes added together, which would be 120 meters cubed. So if you want to make any notes on that, guys, you can, but that would be the answer for that one. So I've got three now for you to have a go at. So you're going to copy, in fact, don't draw the diagrams, guys. You'll be there all day. We're not artists. We're trying to be mathematicians here. So pause the video and just work out the volume of those three compound shapes. Remember, split it up into two cuboids, work each volume out separately, and then add the volumes together. Okay, pause now and we'll go over some answers. Okay, so 396 centimetres cubed for A, 378 centimetres cubed for B, and 204 centimetres cubed for C. Okay? Any that you didn't quite get right, can you put the right answer in? And try and look at it, guys, if you did make a mistake, to see where you went wrong. Okay? Don't forget, pause the video, go back and look at the notes more if you need. That's absolutely fine. Now, that should be enough to take us up to the end of today's lesson. I don't want to go any further because I think the next part we will actually be covering in my lesson. And I just feel like this is a really nice sort of starting block for you to start volume on. Okay, so stop the video now. Excellent lesson. And then in tomorrow's lesson, we'll continue on with this and we'll start looking at other prisms that are a bit more tricky. Okay, see you tomorrow, guys. Bye.